Hi, I'm Graham Glenn, Assistant Provost and Executive Director for Teaching, Learning plus Technology at Stony Brook University. And this is Innovations in Education. In our show, we feature faculty and staff using innovative approaches to teaching and applications of educational technology that have had a positive effect on student learning. In this show, I'm joined by Monica Bugallos, an assistant professor in the School of Engineering, and we will be discussing how student tablet PCs empower the classroom. Monica, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Graham.
Tell me a little bit about the courses that you teach.
Well, I regularly teach one graduate course and two undergraduate courses in electrical engineering. And they are all in communication systems. And then I also teach WISE courses in the Women in Science and Engineering program and also high school summer camps. Basically, the sizes of my courses are for the graduate students like 25 students, and for the undergraduate courses they are about 15 students.
Okay. And I know you're a big proponent of using technology in the classroom. Can you tell me how that has changed your teaching?
Well, it has changed a lot, since, especially since I received a grant from Hewlett Packard 2 years ago, where they donate like 20 tablet PCs mm-hmm. that I can use in the classroom so students can take notes, and they can also do some programming for some activities that I propose.
Okay. And do they also use those to illustrate, do drawings?
Yes. You can go to some, especially for instance, to the summer camp wiki pages, okay. and you will see that they use them to do some schematics of some of the systems that I asked them to design.
Okay. And what's the principal software that they use on those tablet PCs?
Well, it depends. For some of the projects, they use MATLAB in order to do some simulations. Then they also use their own Word or, for instance, some internet-based software.
Okay. Do they use Microsoft OneNote?
Yes, they also use the journal for the tablet PC.
So, because one of the big differences between a tablet PC and a regular laptop is the fact that you can draw on the screen. And for engineering students, that's, you know, especially with all the formulae, mm-hmm. the structural diagrams, whatever, it's an important part of their note-taking process.
Not only that, especially for instance for some of the summer programs that we have, what we do is we divide the class in small groups, okay. and then we take them to different locations, and we are able to exchange information that they write. Or like, for instance, if they go to calibrate an antenna, they can send the information to the people that are in another location, like in the lab, in order to do some design or some special measurements.
Okay. So they're using the tablet laptops in the field, making diagrams, doing research notes, and
taking
then translating
data.
Them back.
Exactly.
To the group.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
When they're in those groups, are they each individually using the laptops, or do they have different roles?
It depends. For some classes, if they are not too large, I give them one tablet for each of them, so they can write the notes of the class for their own. For some other classes, because I don't have enough equipment, then they share it in groups of two people.
Okay. So, how is this different than using paper to take the notes? What has the technology truly done beyond paper?
Well, for some of my classes, for instance, what I ask them is to resolve exercises live.
Okay.
And then they have to submit it at the end of the class.
So that's using the math simulation software.
Yes, so they can embed not only whatever I ask them to write, but they can also include plots that they get from MATLAB or from Excel if they are just doing some processing with Excel.
Okay. So for our uninformed listeners, can you describe MATLAB a little bit and what it does?
MATLAB is a powerful mathematical software where you can just program like in any other language, like for instance C. And then you can, for instance, generate plottings, and you can just run a regular type of programming system.
Okay, so you could manipulate formulas or values, formulas, and see models change dynamically in response to that in sort of real time.
Exactly.
Okay. You teach graduate, undergraduate, and high school students.
Yes.
Do you see a difference in their ability to use technology in the classroom?
Not really.
Not
I
really.
Think they are all born in the computer era, so okay. They are really mastering the computer. I think since they are very little, they are using the internet and all the tools okay. of the computer. So even for high school students that they come and some of them have not been exposed before to programming, mm-hmm. they get it like almost immediately. They are extremely good at it.